It was $483 for.
Man. So he didn't want to get up. I was sitting there for like 10 minutes. Then, this is me off the most is the fact that I came in on Wednesday at like 9 in the morning.
Not using my backup camera either. Look at me. I'm not using my backup camera. So I'll see you later, boy.
All right, what is up, guys? So we're editing the video right now, and I just kind of wanted to put this into perspective on what happened. The next couple clips you're gonna see are previous days leading up to when the engine was still in the car. All right, guys, so we just pulled up. We're out here. I forgot to pull out the camera, honestly. We've been looking around, trying to get this to stay. There we go. So we found this 04 Dodge Durango with the 5.7 in it. Everything looks really good. Caps have been replaced, looks like it. Even the dipstick, new alternator. Everything is has a trans, has all the computer.
It looks like it might have a rear main leak, but if you have the motor and transmission out, you can replace it right there.
Mm-hmm. It's a really, really cheap price. So when we got to the pick and pull, we asked the guys, hey, can I just buy this motor, and can you put like a sign on it that says sold? So they were like, no, sorry, we don't do that. And I was like, all right, that's fine. Just hopefully no one takes it. If someone takes it, then they take it. It is what it is. So that's on Monday. Then I go back on Wednesday because it's raining, and I left the hood open.
Yes, so I just came back to the pick and pull. Recording on my iPhone. Oh, shit. Hood's still open, man. Oh.
No one had messed with it. No one touched it. It was the same. I'll play the clip right now. It got wet. So basically when I got there today, you see the clip right now of us walking up and seeing what happened.
We're thinking about 2-3 hours because the whole front end is gone. I mean, you guys have already seen what the car looks like up to this point in the video. I don't know if you can hear me.
Where's that voice at?
No.
We were just here like 2 days ago. Homeboy was gone. Yep, homeboy's gone. Damn.
At this point in time in the video, the clips you're gonna see. At this point in time of the video, what you're gonna see right after this is when I don't know why I was holding the camera and recording myself. I was just walking around. I was very disappointed in the fact that the engine was already gone.
Wow, that's crazy.
I wonder if they have one in the other yard and how much that would cost.
Someone took
YEET!
Engine.
I was here yesterday or was it the day before you were here?
Day before. I'm so sick, dude. So, basically, we walk back inside. We ask him like, hey, when did someone come and get this? Because literally I was there on Wednesday. Today's Friday. I was there on Wednesday at like 9, 10 in the morning, and it was still there. No one had touched it, no nothing. And so I asked the dude today, I said, so when did y'all sell that engine? He said that at around 11 or 12, someone came in and bought it. And I said, what do you mean they bought it? He said, well, they paid for it and they pulled it the next day. And I said, well, I asked if I could do that, and y'all said no. Honestly, in the moment, I was really frustrated because I had already rented a trailer to get it back home, and I had wasted my friend's time for them getting up at a decent hour. I mean, it's Friday, we didn't have class, so you kind of want to sleep in. But the fact is that I wasted my time, so basically I got screwed. Someone bought it and then pulled it, which makes no sense because they said I couldn't do that. So basically I got screwed in this deal. The engine was, everything was going to be $500, and I got screwed because literally someone did what they said I couldn't do. I don't know what to really say. I'm not mad anymore. I mean, it is what it is. The engine had good compression and everything. There was really nothing wrong with it. I don't know if there's really anything wrong with it deep, if the heads were rusted out, cracked, but from what it looked like a good engine. It was such a cheap price that if it like needed to be a machine or something, I could go get a machine and I'd still be well under $1,000.
This will be it for this video. Number one fail. Let me guys know if you have any engines for sale. 5.7 Hemi, 5-speed trans, computer, and wiring harness at all. Comment down below. Hit me up on Snapchat. It'll be down here, or Twitter, or Instagram, somewhere. I'm going to try and see if I can take this trailer back. And all right, guys. Appreciate you watching. Leave a like. Comment down below. Subscribe if you're new. Share this video. And I'm out.